Hello everyone, myself Dhiraj Chinnekar. I am faculty at Shri Shivaji Commerce and Science College, Motala District, Buldhana. I am from Department of Physics. Here, Department of Chemistry organized one certificate course named Laboratory Safety, which is organized in between 17th to 31st of August. Today's lecture day is 13th day of certificate course. Here, as per name indicate, laboratory safety. In this topic, we have to discuss what are the safety measures for the laboratory. When we enter into laboratory, what type of precautions we have to be taken, and how the instrument handling is to be taken. All types of these safety measures. Why we have to take? We have to discuss in this lecture today, and how will we protect ourselves and the society? Means, if we perform any experiment, then by taking it is in proper way, we will do that experiment and we perform that in proper manner. Otherwise, if we not take any safety measures, then this experimentation will be defected, and that cost ourselves and our neighbors too. That's why we have to learn that safety measures in laboratory. So I am going to take that safety measures topic in one by one in this certificate course. So I am from Department of Physics. So I will discuss safety measures in the physics lab. Right, in we all know what are the instrument present in physics lab. They all almost most of the electronics instrument work on the electric supply, right? So we convert that electric supply by the transformer, right? So we got output which is in low voltage. So if we get shocked by that electric current which is in low voltage, so we don't any type of injury. But if we touch direct current, that is AC current, by 230 to 20 volts, then we will affected definitely. So here some rules and contracts which are to be taken for safety measures, right? So one by one we will discuss what are the safety measures and what are basic, because we perform experiment in our laboratory in low scale. But if we go higher labs, then definitely all these things are very very important, right? So first is familiarize yourself with the basic rule. First we enter into the lab after 12th, passing 12th, and we see the instrument, various instrument in physics lab, physics or any other. But if we discuss particularly in case of physics lab, we firstly interact with some various apparatus. So for that we have to be very careful, and what are the safety measures related to that we have to discuss with your teacher. Teacher will definitely tell you what are the safety measures related to any other of the instrument, right? So first is familiarize yourself with the basic rules. What are the basic rules which is given by your teacher? That basic rule you have to be learned. So second is participation in lab work is contingent upon you following the rule. How that basic rules you learn and you follow that basic rule. The participation, when you participating in lab, what are that safety measures rule, and that are you whether you follow that one or not, that it contains. Serious infraction can result in the disciplinary action and possible removal from the lab activity. If you not following that safety measures, and teacher will observe you time by time, and if teacher will see that you are not following the rules which are given by that you are given by your teacher, or which rule list you are disobeying the rule list, then definitely you are removed from the lab. Contract should be reviewed with and signed by the parents or guardian. When we enter in higher labs, then definitely they sign you contract that you are responsible for your not obeying the law, and we will not responsible for your disobeying the law. That contract should be written. You will be permitted to conduct lab work once you return your signed form, right? If you sign that one and sign form, and then only you will be permitted for the lab work. If you are there is questionnaire, and that questionnaire you have to be read, and that questionnaire after reading you have to submit that I am agree for this, and I am I will perform that experimentation with very sincerely, and I will follow that all types of rule, and I will not disobeying all that rules which are important for that lab safety, right? I will follow that all the rules which are necessary for the lab safety, right? These are the basics. Next, when we enter into the lab, what are the major safety measures, or what are the necessary things we have to do? Because small things is also responsible for that, and you will get affected from your small mistakes, and you also your neighbors, right? Your if you are allotted with the 10 members of batch, and you are performing that experiment, and you are not taking that safety measures, then you will get affected definitely, but your neighbors also you will defect. So small things I have given that in this PPT, and I will tell you how will we responsible student, and how will we responsibly take that precautions. First is remove contact lens and wear goggles during lab work. Yeah, that is the basic rules. If we enter into the lab, we have to perform. When we have to perform, you have to wear goggles. Why we have to wear goggles? Because goggles protect from any inflammations, or if you perform chemical work, then the vapors of that chemical get evolved, and that chemical vapors incident on your eyes directly. If you contact this this glass is used, if you that this type of contact lens is used, then definitely from that graph, yeah, this vapors get affected your eyes. But that if you use goggles that compact in shape, that covers whole area of your eyes, so that you does not affected by that the papers, right? I am giving the example of papers, right? They should be removed before lab at once if chemical are being used, right? Chemical if you use that chemical, then the chemical vapors are incident on your eyes, and that chemical vapor incident on your eyes, and may your eyes get infected, right? So proper guidance, proper goggles are wearing in the lab. In case of any accident, chemical can get behind the lens and cause serious damage before they can be removed, right? If these wafers of liquid are dangerous wafers of liquid are used, and that dangerous wafers get incident on your contact eye, so I will be affected. So these are the first precaution you have to take, that remove contact lenses and wear goggle, right? Wear apron that is appropriate for lab work, right? If we mostly this use in the chemistry, when we perform the chemistry practicals, then some chemicals get affect your what you are wearing, right? Because the chemical reaction takes place, inflammations take place, the chemical get caught, may caught fire, and that fire will affect your body, right? So long neck. So you have to be take precautions what you have to wear for it, and what not, right? So long necklaces you don't have to wear, right? Earrings are very very small, because that if you perform chemical practicals, then that that gases or that gases from that chemical affect your earrings, pendants, necklace, right? So there is precaution has to take, that you don't have to wear long necklaces, earrings, pendants are always dangerous, right? So is loose fitting clothing, right? You have to wear. They can get caught in moving parts, accidentally touch electrical connection, and interfere with the investigation in the some dangerous manner, right? If you wear that cloth, so if the liquid if you take liquid, dangerous liquid, and that liquid is inserted on your cloth, and that cloth get affected, and that's why you have to be precautious, that you have to wear apron, so that if apron is full of cotton and that chemical if incident on that apron, there will be no dusting of your what we are wearing, right? Long tires, if you have long ears, especially in girls, then you have to tie your ears, that's why they get not infected or a burn, any type of burn or any type of reaction that get into the ears, right? Wear shoe that will protect your feet from the chemical spills. If any chemical is incident on the floor and you are going through that floor, and just put that your and that chemical, that then there will be that inflammations or any type of reactions are taken on your feet. So you have to be always wear shoes that if you wear that shoes, you not directly contact with that the dangerous chemical. So wear shoes that will protect your feet from chemical spills and falling object, right? No open tie shoes or sandals, right? No open toes shoe or sandals means you don't have to take wear that sandals and shoes which have the open in toes side. So cotton clothing is preferable to synthetic or cotton wool clothing, more flame retardant. So you will wear cotton cloths most preferably, and that are woolen cloth, that there does not get react easily, and more inflammation retardation means if they caught any type of fire, then this fire does not caught readily, and that inflammation which caught by the fire, that that will be retarded. So you have to use most of the cotton clothing is preferable in the lab and synthetic or to synthetic and wool clothing, right? Horseplay and clothing, horseplay and floating around are strictly prohibited. What it means, horseplay means if you are entering into lab and you are doing his foolish work and you are laughing and you are playing some random place. So that should be avoided when you enter the lab. If you see, most of the students are laughing, most of the students are playing some games, teacher telling some instruction and they are not listening to them and they are just seeing at each other and just laughing. So that type of foolish activity or foolish foolish work you have to avoid, right? Laboratory equipment and apparatus are not the choice. If you are performing any type of experiment in laboratory, then that instrument you have to handle carefully. You have to read all the type of instruction very carefully, what the instruction written on them, then only you have to perform that experiment. Laboratory equipment and apparatus are not the type. They are not the choice. Means they are, this equipment khelne je khelne mantu apan, they are not the toys. Never play in the lab and use the and equipment for anything other than the intended purpose, right? So do not play with the instrument which are in the lab. If we consider chemistry lab, the chemical are dangerous. If we consider concentrated H2SO4, this is very dangerous. If this liquid is contact with us directly, then we get inflammations. So never play with the lab, never play in the labs, because if you play and you are not focusing your instrument or what the teacher says, then some type of accidents are happens inside the lab, and we don't know what the output of that play is to be, right? So be focused and what the teacher said instructions, you have to be listen and perform the experiment with full of concentration, right? Even chemistry lab, physics lab, whatever you take, though both labs have different experimentation, but the safety measures are nearly same, because students' mindset are same, so that's why you have to perform that experimentation very carefully. Keep materials on the lab desks at minimum, right? If you are performing the experiment, you have to keep that material. Means you are taking notes, you are putting some utensils on that experiment table, that should be avoided, because too many papers, notebooks can easily catch the fire in case of the short circuit. If there is short circuit happens, what else? I'm just saying the examples what they are. So too many papers, notebooks can easily catch fire. It's simple basic knowledge. Paper can easily caught fire. If there will be the short circuit, then there will be the catch fire automatically. So you have to take one short diary type of notes and one paper. So you as less as possible you have to use material, right? So next is wiring in some notebook could accidentally cause a short circuit as well, right? So you have to perform, you have to listen what type of measures and what you have to carry with you when you are performing the experiment. When we enter the lab, you have to take very as less as possible material, right? Keep all books materials not in use under the desk or in the safe area. So yeah, here that you have to keep all the books and material not in use under the desk, means which books are not useful for you, just put that books under the desk or the safe area, means outside the lab, or you can keep that material. You can keep that material into your bag, and that bag you can see if you enter into the lab, teacher normally instruct you that please put your bag outside the laboratory or one corner at one the at one corner, and you just come up with pen and one your diary, right? So the purpose for it that you have to keep that material as less as possible, and you have to come with one diary and one pen, because the there is may chances of caught there may be chances of easily catch the fire in case of the short circuit. There is a reason. We just if teacher said that just put your bags outside or one corner, then we will say why this is my bag is very my bag is very costly, and why I put in the corner, and why I put outside the lab. So the for that this is the reason for this, that they can easily catch the fire in case of the short circuit. So what are the what you have to do, that what you don't have to do, that never do this. Work alone, right? Work alone in the lab settings, right? Leave equipments unattached while it operating, right? This should be you have to never do that. Work with your friend, that some part of experiment you have to do, and some remaining part will do others. That we will by taking this, you can discuss the whole practical, how to perform, how you have to take that safety measures. That will that is the reason that behind we do the batch of 15 people and allotted one practical to one or three students. That will they will discuss each other, and what are the safety measures you have to take also they will discuss. So that is the reason. Leave equipment unattached while it is operating, right? Never do the leave equipment. Means when we are operating the instrument, then you have to take care of it, and you have to if you are not using that one, you have to switch off that instrument, and you just put all the materials related to it in the safe boxes, and watch observe carefully all the related instrument are kept into the box, and you switch off that instrument plug, right? Always do read the entire experiment before starting, right? You have to read the practical manual that you provided by the teachers, and you have to read what is AM apparatus, experiment theory, experiment procedure, and your safety, means what precautions you have to take while performing the practical. You see that precautions written at the end of the experiment, that must you have to read, and that practical precautions you have to write in every experiment. If there is no need of any precaution, then why the teachers you said that you have to write precautions at the end? There is need of that one, and you have to write that precaution for every experiment, because every experiment has its different precautions method, right? So that's why you have to write each experiment. Your teachers said that you have to write precaution for every experiment. Why then are not told you that you don't have to write precaution for every experiment? But not they told you have to write that precautions for every experiment, because every experiment has its own precautions. Different experiment, different precautions. That's why you have to write that precautions for every experimentation. Here all the safety symbols and cautions given by the teacher in print are posted into the lab or classroom. So what are the safety measures, safety symbols? If suppose there may caught the fire, and due to that fire, what you have to do? What you have to do? That if you are, you have to before that you have to know symbols, and that safety symbols, if you use that safety symbols, you just that you have to do that symbols to your teachers and or your friend. That's why they will protect you from the collateral damage, right? So this all that safety symbols you have to know, and that teacher and you just take that precautions very seriously. And if catch fire and you have some symbols, if there is catching fire in the lab, then what you have to do? If suppose symbol for catching fire is that, so if you do that this type of symbol, and this symbol suggests that there is catch of fire, so teacher will definitely come as early as possible, and you that will protect you from that causing of fire. So this type of some symbols you have to do, and you have to protect yourself from the damages, right? You can protect yourself because some precautions, if you take precautions, then only that will that's why you have to read entire practical before starting them, and you have to read also precautions. What are the precautions for that experiment? That's why if you perform that experiment and there is missing some point and you perform wrongly, then there will some if that experiment catch fire or any short circuit will be happen, then definitely that symbols will help you for protecting teacher will protect you from that damage. Fire drills. So fire drills means no proper fire drills and emergency procedures, and also the location of fire exit and emergency equipment. So if there is for that in every lab in physics or in case of chemistry, there were the fire drills. That fire drills will be so you have to first that use fire drills, how you have to learn that how to use that fire drills, and by using up that fire drills you have to perform the that if there is caught fire or any chemical spitting will be happen or gas leakage will be happen, there some where different procedure for that, and that will use to protect you from any damages. If your clothing catch on fire, do not, right? Basic rule in laboratory, if there is a caught fire by the short circuit in some other way, chemical incident on your apron, and that caught fire accidentally, then what you have to do? Don't run, right? Do not run from one place to another. Just be calm and just do symbols to your teachers. That if the symbol for catching fire is this, so you said your teachers, you have to thumbs up, and teacher will understand there is catching of fire and you don't have to run for that. Instead, walk to the near safe. If you don't have to run, but what can you do? That walk to the nearest safety shower, stand under it and turn it on. Means if catch fire or any inflammation will be done, you have to walk into the safest place, and safety showers catch fire, you have to go to safety showers and stand under it and on it. Okay? Call to your teachers while you do this, right? And you have to, you know what type of symbols you have to do, and that symbols will help the teachers, so you protect from the other damages, right? You have to because the दिस विल फॉर एवरी स्टूडेंट, द टीचर विल डेफिनेटली लुक आफ्टर द स्टूडेंट, बट दैट दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल. सो इन दैट केस यू हैव टू जस्ट सिंबल, यू हैव टू परफॉर्म सिंबल एंड दैट देन देर विल बी टीचर, एंड टीचर विल से सी दैट वन, एंड ही और शी डेफिनेटली विल हेल्प यू एंड प्रोटेक्ट. रिपोर्ट ऑल एक्सीडेंट्स टू द टीचर इमीडिएटली, नो मैटर हाउ माइनर. दिस इंक्लूड अनएक्सपेक्टेड फिजिकल सिम्टम्स एज वेल, राइट? दैट इज इफ यू आर परफॉर्मिंग एंड सम माइनर एक्सीडेंट्स आर परफॉर्म, दैट एक्सीडेंट हैपन्स, दैट माइनर माइनर एक्सीडेंट्स ऑल्सो यू हैव टू टेल टू टीचर्स एंड इंक्लूड योर वॉट आर द फिजिकल डैमेज यू हैव टू वॉट आर द फिजिकल डैमेजेस हैपन्स यू हैव टू टेल टू योर टीचर एंड शो टू योर टीचर दैट आई हैव when I perform that experiment and due to that one this will happen, you have to tell in detailed manners, right? All and any spills to your teacher immediately, right? Any spills means tell all the things happens and to teachers, and you will teacher will help you from that accident. Note, don't stand on or near the spills, thus increase the chance you will spread the chemical carefully with the mercury found in some old thermometers, right? Thermometers which are everyone see the thermometers, right? If thermometers which is made up of glass, and inside that glass there is mercury, right? So mercury, how we know how dangerous mercury is, so it is carcinogenic, right? So we have to avoid that mercury, in contact with mercury, right? When you put that thermometer, and if you accidentally break that thermometer, then don't touch that mercury by hand. You just have to tell your teacher that this type of accident happens, and they will tell you and they will protect you from that. Don't touch mercury directly with your naked hands, right? You don't have, because mercury is very dangerous, right? So that mercury, don't touch mercury. In also your old tube lights, which is of rod in shape, and which inside that tube lights mercury is present, and then if that tube light switch off, and we take that we can say in local language pili, that rod which is rod, white rod. So inside that white rod, there is presence of mercury, and we after after that rod, you just break that one. You can see that rod. That break that rod, but that is wrong. We don't have to broke that rod in environment. You have to use safety measures for it, because inside that rod there is presence of mercury, and mercury is very dangerous material. So such type of precaution you can take for that, right? I told you what are the fire drills, instead what you do, you don't have to run, you just walk, call to your teacher, right? Tell all accidental report to your teacher, whatever it is, minor, major, whatever type of injury you have to do. The one thing that you have to tell all the report to the your teacher. Second, that if there is breakage of thermometer, then don't be direct contact with don't come in direct contact with that thermometer, right? Next, don't try this. Don't try this means the teacher must approve student design inquiry investigation before the student attempted. Also, the teacher must be present during the class, right? So when you are performing the experiment, teacher, what your teacher, if you allotted one practical and firstly the teacher will perform that and you have to observe carefully, and after that you have to perform that experiment. So before attempting to you, first teacher will tell you how to do this practical, and likewise you have to don't mess up with the instrument. The teacher must approve student design inquiry investigation before the student attempted. Also, teacher must be present during the trials. Whatever will the experiment you are trialing, you are the teacher must be present. Do not perform unauthorized experiment or use equipment apparatus in a manner for which they are not intended, right? So what is the purpose of that instrument, you have to observe first, right? You have to observe first what purpose of that instrument, and you have to perform that experiment for that purpose only, not other than that one, right? Some students were there that they perform experiment and they just try to do something new, and they may mix, if you consider the chemical, they mix up various type of chemical and they have to see what will happen. So that type of foolish work you don't have to do. Never equipment or apparatus in which they, don't use that apparatus for which they will not be intended, right? They are in for the purpose of instrument, you have to fulfill that purpose of instrument which is given in the your practical manual, right? Do not perform unauthorized experiment or use equipment apparatus in a manner for which they are not intended, right? Proceed with the caution. Stay alert in the lab and be conscious, right? So stay alert means what is teacher telling to you, and what type of you have, how the experiment perform, and what type of precautions you have to take, that all these things you have to learn. Be aware of people near or around you all the times, especially when you are about to do something in the lab. So here when you are performing that experiment, you have to focus on that experiment, not to your neighbor who is telling you, right? You have to focus what is given to you, what you have to follow procedure, and what type of output you have to obtain. So this is especially critical when handling the long object, right? Long object is for experiment are present in physics lab. So that long object experiment you have to handle with the care, right? Use extreme cautions when working with hot plates or other heating devices. They don't usually as hot as they are. Make sure all heating devices and gas valves are turned off before leaving the premises. That is the most important. When we see that in some experiment there is heating procedure, and in heating procedure there the student perform the experiment and they don't know what temperature you have to reach temperature of that instrument, but they heating and overheating. So by that, due to that overheating, the experiment you will be in a danger. So read manual properly, and how much time you have to heat the experiment, and what type of how much current you have to provide that instrument, that so as to reach their desired temperature. So they don't usually as hot as they are. Means if you are reaching the experiment up to 100, suppose 100 degree centigrade. So you what type of current you have to supply that instrument and reach the 100 degree centigrade. Don't be worried. Means you are providing constantly and reach the value near about 95 degree centigrade, and you are providing still you are providing that heating. So and due to providing that heating, there are heating, and it crosses 100, 110, 120, but you have to switch off that current early when it is at 90 degree. Suppose the instrument is temperature is 90 degree centigrade, then you are providing the current, stop that provided current, then it automatically reaches to 100 degree centigrade. If not, then only start some heating and just switch off. You have to careful that do not overheat that instrument, so that the any other type of accidents happen. So use extreme cautions when working with the hot plate or the heating devices. That's why the reason that you have to careful the regarding that. If a teacher says you have to heat up to the 100 degree centigrade, you just providing current, and when it reaches the 100 and switch off, and that should be avoided. Because if you switch off at 100 degree centigrade, then their temperature constantly increasing, right? If you switch off and the you switch off that instrument, but still they will hit it and they crosses 110, 120, 130. So that should be avoided during the practicals. So second is, make sure all heating devices and gas valves are turned off before leaving the premises, right? If you are you don't switch off that instrument, then what will happen? There will be leakage of gases, and that leakage of gases will responsible for the burning of laboratory. We heard in the newspaper, or we seen in the YouTubes, that how the accidents happen. These mills caught fire, and these mills caught fire due to that they don't take that safety measures. If you follow the safety measures related to it and you turn off the device before leaving the whole premises of that industry, so there will be no any accidents happen. But if you take the industry or any premises of that industry or factory, that factory get caught by some measures, and after that caught fire, you saw the report that that factory get fire due to short circuit and due to gas leakage. That these are the reasons for that one, that cutting of fire. So if you will follow safety measures, if you follow the proper instruction, you switch off heating devices properly, you are switch off that gas valve properly, turn off gas valve properly, then there will be no any accidents happens. Next, respect electricity. This is the most important point related to it. Respect electricity. Respect electricity means you have to go and just say that I am very fruitful for you electricity, and you just pray for it, praying to electricity. That is not. Respect electricity means what? That when you are performing the experiment related to the electric instrument, you have to take care of the instrument, the procedure, and what type of supply you are providing, and you are using that supply, what type of supply are you using. That's why this is at respect electricity. It defines electricity. exercise cautions when working with the electricity. That means respect electricity means that meaning of that one, that exercise cautions when working with the electric equipment, right? Do not use electrical equipment with frayed and twisted wire, right? We generally saw in the physics lab the wires are twisted and some wire are cut at some point, and you just hold that one, and electric supply is on. Thus, that electric supply on, and you just hold that wire, and you get shocked. So don't use that twisted wire. Use straight wire, right? If you use straight wire, then there will be no cutting of that wire, no losses of electricity. You don't have get the shock from it. Be sure your hands are dry before working the electric equipment, right? If your hands are wet, then there is chances of getting current, right? So be sure your hands are dry before handling the equipment. And do not let electrical cord dangle from the workstation. Dangling cord can cause tripping or electrical shock. Barabar. So do not tell. So all type of plugs or workstation cords that we use in the workstation or in the labs that are do not let electrical current dangles from the workstation. Dangling cord caught the tripping and electrical shocks. That's why you have to use proper precautions and proper following the procedure. Never poke any into the electrical outlets, right? You don't have to poke anything in the electrical outlets. You have to focus on experimentation and what type of supply are you getting, and what type of output you have to get. Generally in physics lab, the transformer are used for converting that current in the low type of current, right? So what type of output we have to obtain, that depend upon the what type of transformer you are using, right? It is fact most electrical shock and accidents happen in the electric wires, not because they spend more time around it, but because they loss of routine safety measures, right? So the most of the shocks are happens due to the your safety measures, not due to the electric, how much times are you are spending into the electric environment, not but it is due to the not taking safety measures for yeah, if you go to MSCB office, there you can see the each and every instrument get electrically neutral, each and every instrument. So that's why when any type of lightning is incident on that electrical instruments, that electrical instrument absorb that shocks and they alert it down to the earth. This is due to because of the earthing. So earthing is very, very important for every electrical instrument. That's why if you do MSCB office, you will see the before constructing that whole MSCB office or electrical instruments, they first prepare the earthing facility. So about under the ground, they do earthing facility, and above to that they set up their instrument, and every instrument has the separate earthing, so that any lightning will incident on that electrical power station, their instrument do not get affected, and that all lightning goes to into the your earth, right? So the role of earthing for the electricity is very, very important, and likewise your instrument too also. Next, lab or at the restaurants, because many of girls, many girls, not boys, you can say that they have habits of taking outside food and just eating that one. Food, beverages, and candy of all types are not permitted in the lab, right? Food, they can carry food, chips, pocket, candies are generally carried inside the lab, but that strictly prohibited because you have to maintain cleanness inside the lab, your desk, your instruments also, right? Never taste the chemicals. You don't have to taste any type of chemical because it's hazardous. You don't have any information regarding to it, and if you taste, you can affected by that chemical. Do not touch chemical or allow them to contact area by bare skin. In chemistry lab, there were many chemicals, and that chemicals do not touch with your bare skin because that chemical will get to your bare skin and inflammations will be happens. Keep work area and apparatus clean and neat, right? You don't have to carry that food and beverages candies inside the lab, and that's why if you avoid that one, you can keep that apparatus and apparatus also, your apparatus area is also be clean. So this is the responsibility of each student that they maintain their cleanness inside the lab. When you enter the lab, lab must be clean, right? Never touch uninsulated wire connected to the 120 volt power line, right? Insulation, I told you, in MSCB, your home also, each your meter is get to the neutral. Do not touch uninsulated, means if there is no earthing provided to you any instrument, don't use that one, because 120 volt power line is very high voltage, and that also gets shocked to you, right? When electrical equipment is present, the lab work area, equipment and your hands should not be wet. That's here, I told you earlier that your hands must be dry, and if your wet hands touches to the instrument, that will get, you will get the shock from it. Never touch uninsulated wire connected to the 120 volt of power supply, right? Above part is same as it. Report any indications of an electrical shock to the teacher. If there you you get shocked by some instrument, just told to your teacher that I got shocked from that instrument. You just have to check their installation properly. Why I get shocked from that? You just report that one. Teacher will definitely help you for that. Never touch anyone who is frozen to the power, right? Means there is two or three students and one gets shocked from it. Don't touch directly to the first one. Second student, don't touch to first one. The basic rule is what? You also get shocked from it. And third, if third one touches you, that third one will also get shocked from second one. So if first get shocked, you just take one material of plastic material, insulating material you have to use. Insulating material touches to them and remove from your friend from the shock. From what if wire cutting wire hold by the first one, then remove hand from that wire from the insulated material. Turn off the power first. Report any indication of the electric shock to the teachers. Right? You have to turn off power supply. That electric power supply you have to turn off, and by turning off that power supply, report any indication to the teachers. Right? You have to tell your teacher that he or she get shock, and due to that, teacher will look at that instrument, and they will Check what will happen actually and why he or she get the shock from it. And this first is what? If first one get shocked, you have to remove him or her by the insulating material, and then switch or directly you can turn off the power. First you have to remove from it, and secondly you have to turn off the power. So this type of procedure you have to follow for it. Third, next is classroom labs maps, draw a map of the classrooms, right? Map, everyone should know what are the labs. If lab get caught by fire, then by seeing the maps they can easily, where is the exit, where is the your shower, they are types of locations are mentioned to your the maps. So class maps must be needed for it. Include the following information: that all of the exits, means from if there is one lab, and how many exits are there to remove from that labs outside area. So all exits must be mentioned in the your lab map. The location of fire extinguisher, right? Where is the fire extinguisher placed? Also mentioned in the your lab maps. Location of the fire alarm, chemical shower wash, eye wash, means all type of the safety measures which are necessary for you for preventing from the shocks or any type of accidental activity. So you have to mention it into the lab maps, that your location of fire alarm, you have to just fire on fire alarm, chemical shower wash, if you inflammation, just go to chemical shower wash. The eye wash means you get vapors of that vapors of the liquid into the eyes. Then eye wash, emergency shut off buttons, power switch, and the sink, the telephones, means you have to call the fire extinguisher for it, and they will come as early as possible to recovery of your accidents, right? So all these are maps, lab maps are necessary. Sir, all such thing we discuss in detail. What are the safety measures for it? What type of precautions? How you handle the electrical instrument? How will you handle the chemical instruments, chemicals in chemistry lab, electrical instrument in physics lab, right? All safety measures are I told in discuss. So you have to look at that one, how you will prevent from the accident. And not just when you performing the experiment you just get shocked, and so somebody, your friends, you are he or she wants to protect you from shock, and just at that time no one can imagine I will also get shock from them, he or she also get shock from it. And so for that, just use insulating material for it, and that insulating material has property not to get shock. For example, you can take wooden stick, right? Plastic rod or something. Don't use metals, they are good conductor of electricity. So if you have chair of metals, so if iron chair is there, or any other chairs is there, plastic chair is okay, but metals chair will not be allowed for it. So by looking to the small things, you can protect yourself from the shocks or any laboratory instrumentation accidents, right? Just look at try to understand and try to apply it further. So I am thank next slide is thank you to Department of Chemistry that they give me opportunity to instruct the student for lab safety measures regarding to physics. I told you physics as well as chemistry too, but these are all for students, and I am very grateful for that they give me opportunity of instructing the students. Thank you, and hope if you have any query regarding to it, just told me in message, right? You ask me any time, and just hoping you understand what are the safety measures and why the safety measures are important for it, right? Thank you very much.